to grow this talent. They have been growing as a team. We've got to grow a whole lot to beat a team like OMG in this particular situation. But they're only one game away. OMG will start game number 4 on the blue side. That is a good start for them, winning their first game on the red. But Gragas and Rek'Sai instantly banned by OMG as the same two AD carries. Uzi still getting picked on as Ryze the third and final ban from OMG once more.
And their plan is very obvious here. They want to first rotate Elise and force World 6 back onto that Echo jungle. They know he couldn't perform. Try to get a repeat.
We'll see what happens if the Elise is banned. Do OMG pick Echo? Do they flex it between jungle and mid? Do they take something else entirely? Maybe they take the Sivir that we've been talking about, but 5 seconds left for Vici. Whatever OMG pick, I think it'll be quick. But let's see what Vici banned first. It is Sivir.
Okay.
Almost misclicked. They take Maokai.
Okay, so they don't even try to go for the Elise.
That's actually a good point. I keep forgetting that Elise is left open. But
that's a champion right now.
Yeah, hasn't won a game in this series, as it turns out. Elise's win rate has not been that good in this tournament, or in promotion, or in playoffs, I feel like.
No, you're correct.
Which is like, if this champion's clearly good.
Both these teams have such a weird relationship with Sivir and Maokai. Like, for the longest time, naturally, Sivir was just running through the LPL, a very important power pick, but I feel like every other LPL team has moved away from Sivir or passed it. But again, just the fact that these two teams are very limited in their styles and what they do, she's still so core to them.
Does World 6 not play Elise? Because he has not highlighted it in any of these junglers. We'll see, I guess. 8 seconds left for Vici in a C. Exactly what they want for these next two picks.
5.14 Evelynn has been changed. Damage has been moved from her hate spikes onto her ultimate.
So a bit better there at 6. Still a fine champion. Seen a lot of success relatively recently. And it is Evelynn Corki that picks there for Vici. Much more aggressive, I feel like.
That's very teamfight oriented. That said, World 6 will have a lot of pressure and control. Paranoia is what I like to call it on the map, just because Eve is in stealth form.
Lovely. Highlights of Carly. Don't think we'll be seeing that one. Cool's close to cracking a smile, chuckling at his teammate. But Elise is open. Lovling's like, no. Rengar only. We'll see what he wants. Lovling's having a fun time. Cool's going to lock in Alistar. That'll be for Sun.
Okay, so still leaving up counterplay potential. Is he going to go Rengar?
I hope so. He is! The Rengar is here for Lovling. Elise is there. He sees the Evelynn, he's like, nope, give me Rengar.
Wow, okay. Cool is definitely playing an assassin.
You think?
Yeah, I do actually.
It's funny how that works out here. Do like the Annie Hover at least from Vici. It was a great pick for Mata in game number 1. And look at Pong, he's reading it. He's like, guys, I don't want it. I don't want to get assassinated.
Team. No, this is actually really cool, too, because if we think about Vici, you know, the thing that they like to do against OMG is spread out, apply pressure across all three lanes when they're ahead, because if they group up, that means that OMG can group up, and you're trying to deny that 5v5. What does Rengar excel at if he gets ahead? Assassination. So spreading up and trying to create pressure in multiple lanes opens you up to a Rengar flank and an assassination attempt. I actually really like the mentality of that pick into Vici in particular.
Yeah. I mean, Lovling just wants people dead. Kind of like Uzi did in the last game here. As Gnar and Braum.
They hold off on the Lulu, like,
the
let's
last few
wait.
Picks. I don't even know if they can pick Lulu now. Pong needs to kind of play a carry. Because they're going to run out of damage if he picks Lulu.
Tell it to Pawn.
And Faker. You. He's good Lulu as well. Like, Lulu can do damage, but that is the highest echelon of Lulu players that eke out every last bit of damage.
Yeah.
That is not easy. Look, I'm not doubting Pong entirely, but.
Okay, so it's we're tricky. Now taking massive pick potential.
This would be so sick. They pick Twisted Fate Twitch. Even just TF, I think, is actually really good into this comp.
Because it's a counter to Eve as well.
But picking Twitch would just be like, this is. Uzi is out of control if he picks Twitch. There's no stopping him.
I just want him to do it, because again, it just forces Vici to group up. Well, okay, he's going to go.
Just about the same pick. He's very aggressive once more. Can't get Corki, takes Graves instead. Sounds like, guys, TF? He's like, yep. Twisted Fate in for cool.
There is never a moment where Vici can be split up. Rengar, TF are on the field. They have to be together.
That sounds bad news for the Vici gaming squad.
Yeah, it does.
Well, we'll see what they last pick here. I think it should be more of a carry here for Pwang. See, Kota's still talking to Sun. He's like, please remember to swap this Twisted Fate. He's like, yep, got it. See if Pwang. I can't help it. See if Pwang. does want to lock in Azir.
Yeah, swap it.
It's great. The OMG are fired up. You can tell just from watching the player cams. Look at Pwang. He's like, I'm not sure. I want to play it. I want to play Lulu. I don't want to get Rengard. He's like, sorry, friend. You're getting Rengard. There it is. Azir picked up for Pwang.
He's got the Emperor's Divide. The kitty jumps at him. As soon as he hears the roar, this is what I feel happens in this matchup. As soon as he hears the roar of Rengard going, Azir's automatically push R. Even if they don't see him.
Maybe.
Any direction, they just push R. Okay.
Not sure how that one's going to work out.
Vici's comp relies very heavily on flanks. Anytime Eve is in a composition, because she can't just, you know, walk front to back, you're going to see her off of stealth. She needs to really rely on creating space and getting to the side or behind a composition to drop her ultimate effectively between five people. That said, you cannot split up against OMG's comp. They have so much pick potential with the Destiny Twisted Fate ultimate, as well as the Rengar ultimate. TF, we've already seen unlimited potential, use TF as a counter to Clear Love's Evelynn, so that's how that works. Obviously, canceling out her stealth.
See the matchups again go going on the Maokai, took it away from Dandy, but Dandy responds by taking his Gnar, leveling on Rengar. That is a trademark pick if we've ever seen one. Versus Weltix on the Evelynn this go around.
Time to go ham.
On the mid lane as well. Pwang back on Azir, but cool. Digging deeper into the champion pool. It's not a pure assassin, but a good pick champion there at TF. And Uzi says it all. Graves into Corki. Uzi really wants to just get aggressive.
They have a very clear game plan. 2v2, put Uzi on a lane-winning champion, put Cool on his specific champions that synergize with leveling and run away.
Yep. And the bottom lane completed. Braum for Marta and Sun on
Alistar,
thank you. Another aggressive engage support. So it's looking good across the board here. OMG have one plan. It was the same as last game. Win lane, win game. Let's see if it happens in game number four. Welcome back as OMG move out of the base as a five-man unit. They won a game. And they're feeling reinvigorated here against Vici, who are still only one game away from taking this series in advancing. But OMG are not going down without kicking, screaming, scratching, biting, and a whole lot of fighting.
And look at the confidence. Normally, you would never make an early level one play in the last game, possibly the last game of a best of five series, because so much could go wrong. But you said it. They're so fired up. They want to run in. They want to kill you.
Yeah. And Dandy actually had to level hop there just to get out as OMG. Five-man invade for some vision. We'll see how deep they let this vision go. But for an OMG fan, there's lots of love here in this comp. Cool and Loveling seem to be going at it again, and even Uzi's back to some old favorites. No more scaling, please. They might actually be caught here. Vici doing something cute.
They've done this every single time when a team makes an invade. They've set up a counter. This is what Samsung White did to Starhorn Royal Club.
Well, not going to work this time. Let's go going. Does face check. The Cool ready with the stun. Are going to flash forward. They want Marta. They're going to get the stun down as well. Damage is there. Marta flashes. Heal used as well. Everyone's flashing forward. And Uzi, he's going to get first blood.
This is so risky, though. It pays off for OMG. But again, the possible last game of a best of five in the playoffs. To make a level one play like that is almost unheard of. OMG are on fire.
Ask Uzi how many windows he gives. He will tell the answer. It is zero. He is just ready to kill people. Already got the first kill in under 2 minutes. And things are looking good already for the fired up OMG.
And they are going to go ahead and call the lane swap. So finding the 2v2 as Schwinn moves to the top side of the map.
I mean, Uzi's fine with this. Hasn't spent his gold yet, but he'll take pretty much any 2v2 he gets thrown at. Especially with a champion like Graves. It's cool lining things up in the mid lane. Getting that farm. It's an interesting matchup for Skurin.
TF versus Azir?
Yep.
I mean, both of them are just going to push in and farm. What do you find interesting about a pastry?
I just feel like it's one of the few matchups where you can play into Azir and not feel like you want to die. Because Azir is such a lame bully, but Twist of Fate's just got such good range.
Yeah, I mean, he's level 2, though.
Get him.
The blue card, the threat.
Blue card is very threatening.
The creep damage that half health him.
Yeah, Tintia's base stats on the other hand. Not so crash hot, but Cool definitely going to be looking to clear out the wave AFK. and then go gank some other lane.
Pretty sure he just lost that lane pretty hard right there. At least until he resets it with initial back.
Leveling on the Rengar, of course. Curious to see where he goes for his first gank. Clearing the jungle out right now. World 6 doing the same thing. Pretty fast clears for both these junglers. Good going, gonna set up. It's in a 1v2 right now. Oh, Dandy slaps on with a wallop.
Wow, so yeah, dodging away from the 2v2. Back into the bottom lane. See how they're going to transition this into Dragon Control as Sen pulls the wave to the side, so trying to get a freeze in front of his tower so they can start denying Dandy.
Expertly done there by Sen, actually. Only level 1 as well, but now hits level 2.
Here we go, though. World 6 now rotating to the top side. Go-Going needs to be careful. Is level 2. Has the Twisted Advance of Kuno. Ooh, he doesn't. He has Sapling to Q.
Good flash. Gets out from under the Q of Mata. Vici been a couple summoners at level 1 as well, so... not so easy. Go-Going escapes the first one. Loveling continuing to jungle up. I think I'll dodge a 2v2 against Uzi as well. Both on the Rift and in real life. He's very scary.
It's one of those players that will almost always take a 2v2, but again, actually initiating the lane swap since he followed Corki to the top side and now came back bottom.
Do you feel like that favors Vici just as far as the macro play goes? Because we saw this in game 2, and Vici knew exactly what to do.
It is if Mata is unlocked and able to roam, especially on a high impact champion like Braum in early levels, which he is now initiating his back. So let's see what Mata does. If he goes the boots ward and starts running around the map and how he impacts it. But if Mata is continues to stay up top, then no, I don't think Vici will get an advantage.
Coming bottom now at least. I think just to complete the duo lane for Dandy, who is struggling despite the small CS lead he has over Maokai. Doing a good job getting some long-range CS with the boomerangs, but not very fun. Might is going to come and try and make it a little bit more bearable.
Just kind of hanging back in Fog of War, assisting World 6 on his Gromp. What they're trying to do is check for Loveling to invade. They think a tower dive is possibly coming down, so they've set a trap. So now they see that Loveling is pushed in, hiding in Fog of War. They want him to come around and get a counter engage.
Great ward there. Smart from World 6. Now they'll all move out together. Loveling knows what's happening. He gets tagged by Braum Q. Throws out the ball and tries to call its reinforcements. Teleports down. Good combo there from San. Uzi going to try and make it count, but he can't quite get it done. World 6 getting low. Cool's come in, though. Now he's caught out of position. Will get stunned up as well. And VT Gaming in a very scrappy skirmish, fighting nicely as Mata gets the second kill.
And what did you say, Pastry Time? You asked the question, you know, if Mata is allowed to roam, impact the map, what'll happen? That's what'll happen.
Mata happens.
Mata happens.
And VT Gaming pick up 2 kills. For the price of 0, I believe, a very clean trade.
And it was a beautiful trap setup. Again, you know, knowing that the wave was getting pushed in, they set up to expect OMG's dive, standing off to the side, making sure that Mata didn't just run down the bottom lane and show himself immediately, luring Loveling into it.
And that's the best way to play against OMG. You know they're aggressive, let them fall on their own sword. And Veach doing a nice job with a slight lead here in this game. Not big enough yet to see Vici really carry it home, but a good start at least. 600 gold after giving Uzi that first blood.
Things now returning to normal. The question is going to be, how will these teams approach Dragon? We've seen Vici throughout this series manipulate the map pressure to get a numbers advantage on Dragon as opposed to taking a full 5v5. And the few times when OMG have come out ahead, it's because they finally get that big team fight. But here comes Destiny.
Yeah, cools all things down the bottom side. Dandy stunned up. That's a very clean kill. And Cool walks out in style.
Yeah, kind of interesting that Dandy would be that far forward, especially with Destiny up and available.
Bit mistimed there, but Cool. Happy to take the kill. Double Doran's as well, actually. We talked about that last game as being a win lane sort of indicator. Goes back, gets his cooldown boots. He is ready to gank.
This is pretty classic Pawn and Cool Twisted Fate build.
Yeah, this build's really developed a lot recently. It's just very popular. Getting that early CDR.
Use Destiny as many times as possible. We've talked about the assassination and pick potential of all of these champions. Rengar and TF.
Especially together, which I'm sure OMG are going to try and put together. But right now, Loveling trying to get to that level 6 so he can really up that ganking potential. But the Vici security system in the red buff means that Loveling is struggling to take this safely.
Yeah, and again, Mata doing a great job keeping track of Loveling. That's been a key point to their success in World 6 and Mata continually invading on him and minimizing his impact in the early game. Does manage to find that pink ward, however.
Xuan rotating up as well. They might contest for it. San has spotted them already. He's trying to kick them out of the jungle. Or headbutt them out. Can't finish the red safely, though. Cool's not there. He doesn't have his ultimate.
And a big thing is the fact that Eve is in stealth, so they expect World 6 to be behind them.
Oh, San just going in instead. Uzi going to drive in as well. Xuan's a target, but Mata puts up the unbreakable. Pwong gets a nice counter kill there. And he'll get the first one onto Alias. Loveling's forced to flash the wall. Pwong going to ride his way in. Uzi with a sick flash. Gets himself out as Gogoing's now joined the fray.
Here comes Dandy.
Knocks them back here, but Dandy's going to join in as well. He's almost Meganar. Gogoing getting chased out of it. And Vici again win the skirmish. Two kills for nothing.
They're winning the team fights. Yeah, it wasn't a full 5v5 because they backed out, but all 10 members are on the bottom side of that map. And Vici being so proactive on the back of Mata's vision control.
Oh, now Loveling as well. Agony's Embrace just tags him. And Xuan's going to get the kill.
They look like Samsung White. No, this is exactly how Samsung White dismantled Starhorn Royal Club in Game 2 of the Season 4 World Championship. They got an initial first blood, although Uzi got that one, but you know, tried to set up a level 1 play.
Now San's going deep, trying to get a kill, but he's getting stunned. He's dead. OMG are throwing themselves too aggressively at Vici, and they're fighting back this time.
They got an advantage after setting up the trap on Loveling, immediately translated that into invading his jungle, deep warded, contested the red, and it's just starting to snowball. These tiny little paper cuts, these little advantages just amass further and further.
Not that little, especially with the way Vici are playing. Matching the aggression in some ways here for OMG. Like you mentioned, sort of letting them get baited themselves and setting up those traps. That Vici are responding well. This is not what I expected from them here in game number 4. But it's great to see again another side of the ever-evolving Vici Gaming.
Looks great for them in playoffs as well. You know, if they do manage to find the win here continuing forward, this is, we talked about how OMG, this is the best form that we've ever seen them in. This is the best form Vici has ever been in.
And that's the great thing about playoffs. Teams always step up when playoffs roll around. We haven't even seen the top 4 teams play yet. The Gauntlet itself already delivered some great matches. This series, no stranger. And Vici do find themselves with a decent lead, but it's not massive.
Just, I'm having flashbacks to when Insect's jungle was lit up by like 20 wards. That's exactly what that looked like. Mata.
Well, that's Mata. Great vision control. That's a massive understatement. As Pong returns to the mid lane, got his blue buff, got his Morelli Nomicon. More than happy to match pressure now against Kul. And Loveling's trying to make some plays here on the Rengar, but World 6 playing it safe. Maybe not safe enough.
Destiny is up and available.
Cool uses it. They'll get a kill. He doesn't know that. World 6 does see the ward. We'll take the Raptor camp away, and Mata should know it's there. Now I'm going to see it. World 6 will take it out.
I'm actually really surprised that Kul didn't pull the trigger there. They had Rengar ult and Destiny available. And like you said, they had a numbers advantage on that side of the map.
Loveling now going topside. Wants Dandy. They're going to gank Dandy again here on this Gnar. Stun card comes out. He's Mega Gnar, but it might not be in time. Crunches out of the way. Mata goes in now as well.
Wow.
And the counter engage is going to come onto Kul. Mata, huge ult that gets onto 3 as Kul goes down. And Agony's Embrace is out. Gogoing's forced to flash away. And Vici Gaming reading OMG like a book.
So many resources expended to try to take down that Gnar. They couldn't chain CC, didn't have the damage. Dandy gets the Mega Gnar. They find the counter engage. Fantastic play from Vici.
It is very hard to chase a Twisted Fate like that. And Vici made that look simple. Very easy.
They're out skirmishing OMG.
Yep. Looking good right now in game 4. Not going to roll over and die, it seems like. Vici, in fact, they'll do quite the opposite as they take the mid lane tower. Uzi did get the bottom lane turret as well. So there's a bit of a gold trade there and a bit of space on either side opened up. But Vici Gaming looking good. 2,000 gold ahead now.
Starting to amass. Again, Dragon has yet to be contested at 12 minutes into this game, so OMG having the bottom tier tower down, they have more control over that side of the map technically, but a little bit scary to chase into this Vici composition, especially because they do have the gold lead, although Xuan hasn't bought in a long time.
Hasn't got his Trinity Force just yet.
Yeah.
Falling behind a bit on CS there to Uzi as well. It should be okay. Uzi's got double AD items, nice and aggressive.
It's not about to be okay though.
Nope. San's coming down. If he wants it, San's going to back away. Uzi more than happy to play in this 1v1. Knows that Xuan doesn't have a tower, so it's all okay. Vici gonna go back, probably spend some money. As soon as that Trinity Force hits for Schwan, I think we can expect Vici to
be he should have it now.
Be a bit more proactive.
No, just the zeal ingredients.
Not quite. Vici pinging him to that dragon.
It's like 600 gold short.
Not there right now, but maybe doesn't need to be. World 6, going to start the dragon. Seems that they've spotted a couple backs. Very nice timing here from Vici. Understandable.
Yeah, they have the gold lead. They have advantage over the dragon pit. Still slightly curious that OMG aren't going to even attempt to make a front for it, because again, you have Destiny available, so you can face check that fairly safely. And likewise, Uzi technically has an item advantage over Corki because he doesn't have the completed Trinity Force, and you had your two flat AD items. Maybe a misstep from OMG, but we'll see how they play around the next 6 minutes.
Cool finally has a Shane. Part of the issue with that last gank was the Aether Wisp, which doesn't do too much for you as far as damage goes, but Lich Bane coming online early for Cool. Going to be going for that nice and aggressive skirmish slash split pushing style build.
And he always itemizes the Lich Bane versus the Hourglass. We have leveling, sneaking to the back of the pit. But since San was spotted out by this ward, Vici have exactly an idea what's happening.
I think I might have spotted leveling as well. I think he just faded into stealth in range. And regardless, Vici, play it safe with some nice forward vision.
He's trying to make a play on the opposite side of the map.
We're going actually. Ooh, good wave clear. Get some couple turrets hits down onto Schwan's Corki. And OMG trying to open up more space and pressure Vici. But Vici more than happy just to take it as it comes. Give up the tower. See if they can get an advantage somewhere else. OMG though, go up 2-1 in towers. And that gold still sitting very even 14 and a half minutes in.
Yeah, for once OMG attempting to shore up this game by objective control, whereas Vici are finding their advantages based off of team fighting. So a bit of a role reversal.
So the nice thing about long best of fives is that you get a lot of adaptation and kind of into metagaming of the series itself. Both teams adapt. Vici, they knew they had to adapt. If they'd won 3-0, they might not have learned too much. But after getting smashed in game three, it's nice to see a good adaptation here from Vici.
Yep. Both sides looking fairly even right now. But again, I expect the next big explosive conflict will be over that next dragon.
And still, despite the way Vici have played, I feel like they're still trying to either trick OMG into doing something silly and capitalizing, or just waiting for OMG to come to them and then exploiting that reactively. Vici's, you know, they're not OMG. They're not going to instantly turn into this hyper-aggressive team after just one game.
No, you're absolutely right. They're still, you know, playing around the map, trying to find a numbers advantage. They are technically stronger in items now that the Trinity Force has been completed.
Seems like they might make a play with it as well. Schwan down the bottom side, good going, knows he's going to die. He backs away so that doesn't happen to him.
But again, you know, Vici playing the map, looking for picks as opposed to consolidating the resources and looking at the 5v5. And OMG are doing a good job reacting to this and trading objectives evenly across the board. You see Uzi now on the top side with Zarn getting some decent damage on second tier top.
Might get it, but Dandy's going to come in and protect it. Kind of ran out of minions there. Dandy will scoop those up. And OMG will back away.
So both teams having a bit of an adaptation.
Yeah, I mean, again for OMG, they didn't get the super aggressive start they wanted after that first blood. Weren't able to capitalize, so I feel like sort of move things back, look for their item spikes, and then fight when it's important. OMG might be aggressive. They are certainly not reckless. Not all the time.
It's just so interesting. Typically in the last possible game for a series, you would take a hyperscaling AD carry, and again, you wouldn't make a risky level 1 play. Yes, their level 1 is absurdly strong with Graves, Alistar, Twisted Fate, Rengar. Like, level 1 on OMG is disgusting. But that could have gone so wrong so quickly, and you would have lost the game off of an early snowball.
Sure, but not going to win that way. If you don't play aggressively as OMG into Vici, you're likely destined to just have games 1 and 2.
I just love it that it's so OMG.
Yeah, they know. They found the win condition.
It's very atypical of a best of five or a best of series anything.
And now Vici still trying to play that map. Cool's actually popped the Destiny. He's got a Lich Bane now. Found the pick here. It's actually World 6 they want though. Get him. The ult's out there. Might not be enough as Uzi comes in as well with his Graves ulti. But Marta, good little disengage there. Pwong going to ride them out there as well. The carries are isolated out.
Here comes Good Going.
San's getting tanked up. Good Going. Gonna try and be the front line here, but he's actually getting CC'd out. Gets scooped back as well. Oh. San misses the flash. Pulp. And Dandy taking punishment. Still no one dead. Cool might be the first target though. Dandy jumps in. They want it. They get it. Corki gets that kill.
Pwong came in and separated a nice fight, created two different fronts, and again, Vici get the better in a 5v5, but it's because of how they control the terrain, turning it into a, I want to say a 4v3, a 4v2 for majority of that fight.
And look, if Vici are going to be team fighting, that's the sort of fighting I expect. Not the full-on run at you 5v5, because OMG, make a nice counterplay here. Get the mid lane out of turret for themselves.
Best case adaptation that they had available. Now Schwinn will trade it for the top tier tower, so technically in gold, it's even across, still in favor of Vici because they took the team fight, but OMG do even out a lot of map pressure there.
3,000 gold up now for Vici, as they'll look for Dragon in 55 seconds or so. The Pillgewater Cutlass now coming on for Schwinn. Gonna be his second item here, Blade of the Ruined King. Rabadon's coming out for Pwong as well. And looks like Zhonya is going to be the second item there for Kool. So, first items are out. We've had those few initial fights. Both teams now working on their second items. And of course, second dragon will be back up as well. So, pretty important point as we approach 20 minutes in this one.
And Vici are putting themselves in a position to get down these deep wards. Likewise, also looking for a... they're looking to set up a trap and to pick off Loveling, but Son figures out what's happening, has a nice ward over the Krug pit.
Nice stuff there. Vici can't clear it just in time. He will get the red buff, or at least attempt to. Sun is on a ward as well, so Marta will scare him away by throwing a chair at him.
Kool is going into full split push pressure mode, so OMG, I think they're actually just going to go ahead and sacrifice this, although Kool does have TP should they decide to look for a 5v5.
Not going to make it all the way down from top lane, but run pretty fast between there. Has teleport as well, actually. Going for that very popular double global Twisted Fate build. Vici gonna move down, try and take the turret first. They'll work on the dragon later. If they open up more spaces, Uzi ults the wave. Much easier for them to take it. Ooh, Sarn, good double vault. Marta gets out though.
Meanwhile, Kool gets the top tier tower and is continuing to push, which is why you see Dandy starting up his back to answer this Twisted Fate.
It's good play from OMG. Protected the bottom tier 2 turret. And that's actually kind of all they need. Kool's even moving down to mid now and pops his ulti just to get some vision.
Dandy does not have teleport, so they can look for a 5v4.
Oh, Kool's actually ulted in. He's looking for something. He doesn't have flash. No ghost either, so can't quite rush in there. I think he just wanted to escape. Gets on the right side of his team.
They technically have better posturing over the dragon, although Uzi is responding to the bottom creep wave.
Has to get that farm, and that will give Vici the dragon. OMG, little misstep there from the AD carry. Marta going to block those wild cards, and dragon number 2 will go over to Vici.
So in the end, everything shakes down, and it's going to be top tier tower versus dragon. So going to go ahead and give that one over to, what's their faces? OMG. That Twisted Fate player guy. That's not Messiah. It's cool.
It is cool. You're not being mistaken.
No, I definitely think that's a much better trade, especially because it's only dragon number 2. Now, fifth dragon win condition is set up for Vici so far, but you're still very deep down the line.
And I like the plan. Kool's actually back in the bottom lane. Gonna split push there now. It's smart from OMG. Direct encounters aren't really this team comp strength, it feels like.
And it's really smart against Vici again, too, because they want to pull you around the map. What are you looking at?
This is cool. DSing in the mid bottom lane. Fine doing the same thing at top. Baron is up, but probably not contested right now. Everyone just moving towards their next few items. Again, this series in particular, I guess just Vici games. Do you feel like these teams just... Oh, sorry, do you feel like Vici, excuse me, just do nothing but wait between dragons? Sometimes it feels that way.
Yes.
How do you think that works?
It's also kind of the play-by-play mentality that's like, oh, if a team's not doing anything, if they're just waiting
Look,
in between
I'm
dragons.
Not they're not doing anything.
They're just manipulating map. OMG and most teams do a good job kind of mirroring them so they don't get free objectives because the LPL across a majority of teams are very good at trading objectives or securing theirs. So
I just want to say, if I like play-by-played all of the map movement during a six-minute window between dragons...
Farming creeps in the mid lane!
I don't think the audience would last through that broadcast. That would be very intense.
Dyrus pushing creeps.
Oh, it's dead. It's going to be Pwong picking up that blue buff. Dandy gonna donate that over. Still got that jungle of blood in him. Oh, Sarn actually might have found a catch here. Might is gonna get knocked back into the smoke screen, but just gonna walk out of it. In fact, might get stunned here. Ulti's gonna wear off relatively soon. As it turns out, no one's gonna die. But Sarn made it close.
Yeah, OMG not pulling the trigger. Had Destiny available as well. Now Kool may be forced to use it.
He is. Goes to the red buff. of all places. Is this the counter gank?
The trap trap? Oh, he's trapped.
The double bluff trap? Oh, World 6 might be trapped. I think I spotted him with a back end of Destiny's vision. And OMG. Clearing priority vision around the dragon now. Beachy, though, as always, have excellent vision set up in the area.
Dandy is also standing in Fog of War looking for the teleport.
Yeah, that's aggressive. Gogong's going to be forced to flash. Dandy's going to hop over after him. He wants it. Tron's going to back over as well. Don't think they can catch him. Gogong does a nice job of dodging the slows. And OMG going to reposition, maybe look for a 5v5 here.
Both of these teams posturing, looking for a single pick for Baron. Dandy did a great job utilizing his rage bar, stacking that up and preparing it.
Instead, have to disperse once more. Wait for the next buff.
There is now a discrepancy between teleports, which is why you immediately see Gogong rushing down to the bottom side, because they have an open window where they can start really playing with split push pressure.
And of course, plays to the bottom. It's so interesting to me that OMG are making slight adaptations to be a little bit more like Vici. Not too far, just a little bit more.
Mm-hmm. Trying to play Vici's game, beat them at it. It's like a hybrid of OMG and Vici. They just like crashed together so hard last game that this new little OMG popped out.
given the intensity of Game 3, that is not the worst theory. Zuzi.
But I expected kind of a slower pace game from OMG. Yeah. Again, in what could be the final game of this series.
Can't come out guns blazing every game, is that what you're telling me?
No, it's just, again, you don't want to, you know, risk your entire series because you make one bad mistake where you fall behind early. Typically, teams in the last game of a series will always play hyperscale. Jinx, Fang, Kog'Maw, things like that, because they expect that everyone's going to be playing super safe, and it's going to turn into a 55-minute slugfest.
Do you think it's a mentality thing as well, where OMG win the first game and like, okay, we can actually beat them? Like,
that's what I think it is, just historically from OMG, because they are such an emotional team, very charged.
Yes. That's a good way to describe it. As World 6, going to take that grump away. He's spotted by a ward from OMG and Dragon. Give me the next point of tension back in a minute 10. Have a quick check-in with the items to see where...
Has it been 6 minutes already?
Almost. Not quite, Froskuren. Just 5. We'll check in to see where these teams are up to as far as items go. Kind of gauge where that next fight's going to go. So Lich Bane, Zhonya's and half avoid stuff there as well. 6 is space checking enemy jungle. Ulties, because, you know, you got to send a message.
If you're not going to ulti over the red buff, when will you ulti?
With the dragon fight that's in 40 seconds.
Okay, let's talk about itemization. So I don't think that there's a clear winner or leader here in terms of itemization, but it's very different on how these compositions will execute. Big pick is going to be the completed Zhonya's Hourglass for cool, so that opens up a lot of pick potential. Likewise, he has the completed Lich Bane, which is why we see him in that top lane. Again, Dandy doesn't have the teleport available, so by creating a pressure point in the top side, pulling Dandy up there, it automatically gives OMG a numbers advantage towards this dragon fight. Unless Vici can either shred or poke them down between Corki and Azir, I think they just need to give this one up. Because if they lose the 5v5 here, or I should call it a 4v5 since Dandy can't be in position, it's automatically a Baron.
And Dandy clearing the wave out now. So there's a window for OMG. It's a pretty big one as well with that teleport quite a whiles away. But OMG not quite comfortable just yet. Dandy's coming back now as well. Cool's getting blue buff. So gonna delay that potential dragon. Vici are on pace for dragon number 3, and that sets up the 5th nicely. So OMG, if they can, do want to stifle them here.
They should have pulled the trigger when Dandy was across map. Allowing Dandy to get back with his team was a pretty big mistake from OMG.
See if they get punished for it. A bit of poke there from Dandy in his boomerang. Needs to build up a bit of rage there as Cool takes out that sun turret. But OMG now going to collapse together. Vici have already started the dragon, though.
Watch the rage bar. It's all going to be how Dandy acts as the front line.
Ooh, dragon not stolen. Gogong going to go in, though. Damage is there. Vici happy to fight 5v5. World 6, though, gets absolutely destroyed by Cool. But he pops his ulti again. Dandy with a huge ulti. Managing that rage as he pops through against the wall. Cool trying to kite his way back as Wong goes down. Loveling's in the backside trying to take out World 6, but he's getting kited. And Cool, he can't get through the ulti, but Nshuan, he's the one with a double. Make it 3, maybe, as Uzi might go down. Sun makes a huge play. Uzi does get a kill. But Sun's going to get tagged by the looks of things. Cool's trying to get him out safely. Gets damage onto Dandy. World 6 round the side. Good headbutt there from Sen. It's not enough, though. Dandy going to get the kills, and that's the ace.
Absolute disaster for OMG. They didn't pull the trigger. Just engage. They've had an advantage for so long, and they're just too cautious. When Vici are the more decisive team as the green members, they've been... Let me list the ways that this should not have happened.
Well, it's happening for us, Gurren. Vici Gaming...
Vici Gaming, the green members in comparison to the legacy players that OMG have, they speak two different languages. They're communicating in a third. Their roster swapped out. Let's have a replay. So the big thing here is going to be Dandy getting this massive Gnar ultimate. We talked about how good Dandy is at micromanaging the rage bar. Just speaks volumes there. Dandy shouldn't have been in that fight. They should have pulled the trigger when he's up top lane. From here, World 6 is going to go ahead and kite around Loveling. Loveling misses his Bola around that corner. And then it's just VG piling in on OMG. Doing a beautiful job playing janitor and cleaning up all these extra kills.
And look, you can look at what OMG didn't do here, but let's look about what Vici did. They won a 5v5 against OMG.
They won a fantastic team fight. They look great right now.
They do look excellent as Vici. We're going to close out this game around the Baron buff as well. They'll meander because they know they've got the vision. They feel confident now that they can win fights. And they've started the Baron. Cools in bottom lane. He does have his TP. He ultis for vision, but Vici have already got the Baron.
Free objective to Vici Gaming. They've now opened up this lead to 4K. Now looking for more.
Sun's caught. Does get stunned up. He'll die to Pwong. Cool still on the bottom side trying to make something happen. But someone will go back. It will be Dandy with that empowered recall. But and the rest of Vici will run down mid.
Exactly. It's going to be second tier bottom for second tier mid.
Cool actually has to back off. Daddy's chasing him away now, so it's 4v4 around that mid-side turret.
They may be able to break the inhibitor. Uzi is still up and alive. Cool, teleporting back to safety.
Sorry, 4v3. His son is also dead. I got the pick there as well. Vici, you don't really need it. Going to break that inhibitor. We're not going to quite get the inhibitor itself just yet. But Danny can come if they want. He's got TP. He's actually really mad.
He's coming in from the side.
Yep, good time to go. Dandy is mega for about half the duration longer. He's got about 8 seconds left to make a play. It'll just zone them off this. They'll take the inhib. And Vici Gaming do not lose often from this spot. Loveling going to get caught far too far forward as that's a kill. Now Marta going to attack Sun. Pops the unbreakable. Vici going to close the trap and try and win the game. Sun's going to go down again. Uzi's trying to get the escape off. World 6 is too far forward. Marta's dead as well. World 6 actually lived somehow, but Marta did die.
Vici going full OMG instead of taking the surefire whittle down at the Nexus turret. They look for a tower dive and lose two members, but... lose a member, but they've still got some steam left.
Yeah, they've proven they can do it. They're shredding through these towers. Vici Gaming may just beat OMG at their own game. Cool, he pops his Zonies to buy some time, but they go for the kills. Tron gets the first one. Uzi takes out the next. He's gone absolutely ballistic, but they're outplaying them.
Oh, here comes Loveling.
And Loveling's going to close it all off. Pwong can't ult in time. World 6 going to turn it around with the help of Schwan. But the bowler's good. Sun will lock him up. And Corki will die. Maybe Baron up creeps. Made that very close.
And uncharacteristically, Vici go for the style points as opposed for the win. OMG certainly on the back foot, but they do have time yet.
Technically alive.
Technically breathing.
The best kind is OMG. We'll just barely avoid defeat at the hands of Vici. The Vici look really angry after that last game. They are playing. They're doing their best OMG impression. Impressive, given that they only had about 3 games to learn it.
And they've quickly opened this up into a pretty sizable gold lead, approaching close to 6K. It's about 5K now.
Looking good, and they've got that item lead. Dragon 4 coming up as well. They can take that as their insurance policy, but OMG's base is wide open.
They could have just consolidated down the Nexus Tower, at least opened up the Nexus right there. So, again, I'm just so shocked about this new flavor of Vici that we're seeing emerging, and it's awesome.
I know what you're talking about, Frostgrim. Vici Gaming do this every game.
Yeah, they're just a really 5v5 team fight-oriented team. Yeah, they just love to kill people.
Hyper-aggressive.
Yeah.
Totally.
In your face.
Well, this game certainly. Might attack Sun with a Q, throws the chair at him. Looking for blood.
Get in there.
You might just do that. Don't tempt Vici. They've been angered. and they are ready.
They have awoken.
They have honestly, they have awoken.
This is like little, they're like little baby Samsung White right now. Like skirmishes all over the place. You know, they deep ward you. They try to beat you around every single corner. Anytime they think that they have a numbers advantage, they make a pick, snowball them to objective.
They're at least standing on two legs at this point. If they're baby Samsung White,
it's the two dandy Amata legs of Samsung White.
Yeah, I think they stopped crawling after game number three. They're looking great here in game four. I don't think I ever want to be in a game five against OMG for all of my LPL playoff marbles. So Vici are trying to close this one out now, but there is still life left in OMG. Not much, but a number higher than zero is still better than none.
Uzi has completed three items. He's now working on his Blade of the Ruined King. Fourth dragon is about to open up for Vici. So again, we've talked about that fifth dragon win condition. They use that a lot in the LPL. They have one of the highest control or dragon control rates out of any team. I think EDG might be sneaking up on them with their recent performance.
Yep. And it's how VT like to play. Still objective focused, despite perhaps newfound aggression.
Bloodlust.
Yeah, it's good to see. You can see Mata dance around the front lines looking for some cues.
Mata on a playmaking champion. 1-2-16 this game out of 19 kills. So he's participating in 17. You cannot let this guy have it. He's a fantastic Janna player, but Janna is not a playmaker like Thresh, Annie, Braum, or Alistar.
It is not. And it does make a difference. I don't know what VG had after this, before this game, excuse me, but it is working out.
Mata got unlocked. The difference between this game and last game was he played Janna. Again, he's a great Janna player, but as soon as he was unlocked at level 1, roamed down and picked up that initial skirmish, from then, every single team fight has been Mata.
Well, we're going to try and make one last one here. VG do not need much to win this game. Sieging the bottom turret now.
Waiting for the super creep wave in the mid lane.
Absolutely. Vici still not going to make too many mistakes. World 6 can actually move around and just try and pressure Uzi off these creeps. But I don't know if he can fight 1v1.
I don't think he can. He's got three items, as well as the Bilgewater Cutlass, so he'd be able to kite Eve pretty effectively.
Not recommend fighting an angry Uzi. It's almost as scary as angry Vici.
Just going to Hulk out.
And Vici this game. Well, certainly OMG in game number 3. But if they want a 5, OMG are going to have to defend here. Not sure they can afford to give this turret up. Certainly, I don't think they can afford the inhib, but Vici getting the pokes in. Chuan's got that Trinity Force taken away. It's only a matter of time.
And
that's
again,
the Vici motto.
Death by a thousand paper cuts, just quickly whittling away. I think, though, with the...
Baron.
Yeah, well, Baron and also the Rage Bar. As soon as Dandy popped that, it then gave OMG the go-ahead to say, okay, as soon as he's in Meganar form, we can look for the counter-engage, so...
That was the TP.
Look for the counter gauge as soon as he's in Mininar form, which is why they all back up.
Yeah, Gogong did port. He's going to lose it now.
Reset for Baron.
Sans on a ward. They do not go for it. They want the Baron instead. Good play here from Vici. They're going to pick up some more items, but cool. Has been bought some time. He actually ports bottom side. He does have TP. Gets a bit of vision. Knows they're all in base, so can safely get to Baron for about 20 seconds and clear some vision.
Trying as quickly as possible to alleviate the pressure on the bottom side of the map while he has a time window to do it.
Good play from Cool. Again, we expect OMG to play well under pressure. Doesn't get much more high pressure than almost losing your LPL playoff series. And Vici did not end that game. They tried to get a couple more kills to really seal it. And instead, find themselves a little bit further on the back foot than they might have expected. Still 5k up, but that gold lead's been static for a couple minutes. And Baron's one off. Vici know they have to win probably one more fight.
I'm just so shocked that Vici went for that. Diving the Nexus Towers. I feel like their actual motto is almost like, just take the objective. Like, when they get a dragon, just walk away. Just walk away from it. Just got it for free.
Vici's team fighting has looked a lot
much better.
Like,
Dandy again, on Gnar, it's fantastic.
And we've seen this before from Vici. They've had moments of team fighting, but this is a tough spot to pull it out in.
Their team fighting actually got a lot better when Dandy switched to the top lane. Not saying that Dandy's a better top laner than a jungler, but giving more gold to him in the top lane empowers what he can do for a team. And Dandy's a great mechanical player. He's a very smart player about who he engages team fights. Obviously, the top lane champions are much more influential majority of the time in team fights. I mean, obviously, that's up for debate between like Gragas, but Gnar for sure.
Well, Cool popped his ulti. Dandy's lost his Banshee. Loveling gonna try and steal it. Can he get it? No! It goes to World 6 and Loveling's almost dead. Vici still fighting off here as OMG going to make one last ditch effort. Hooker going to get stunned. He will fall down to the Braum passive. Cool's going to stun them as they run away. But Vici get the one pick they need. It's actually a trade though. Dandy did die.
One for one, but they get the Baron. Oh, maybe more.
Schwan, not good times. It's a little too much. Marta flashes forward with the W to try and keep them safe. Luckily, Cool doesn't have that ulti, but Sarn is hungry. Will not find a combo.
They just need to go back, reset, sacrifice mid-tier tower, but they need to take care of their waves.
Yep. Wong's trying to get them off his teammates as they run away. OMG have some nice wards in these entrances, so able to see them run. But Empowered Recall is going to make this a bit easier. Schwan in the top lane going to clear that out. And OMG will get a Tara, but how much more can they get? VG have already gotten back.
It's pretty much the only consolation prize. At this point, they need to stall out VG's Baron for as long as possible. Rotate around the waves, continue to force them in. Take the jungle, possibly look at sneaking a dragon, although would be risky. And VG just need to start resetting their map.
That's exactly what they'll do. Schwan in the top bottom lane, sorry, will clear out all those minions. Dandy going to waddle down here. Blue buff going to go over to, I think, Quan. I'm ready to receive it now. And Dandy going to get the Scuttle Crab again. The Jungle of Blood. No, it's the Vision Blood. He's being commanded by Marta to scout out the wards.
Ping, ping, ping.
It's Marta. And we'll start the Scuttle Crab. Dandy watches on in horror. His teammates take his jungle. Oh, Wong actually might have been caught here. He is caught. Kill not quite there though. He's protected by the Zhonyas. All out there from Marte. How did he get out of that? Vici played very well to keep their mid laner alive.
Didn't even burn heal. He still has that available.
Dragon's up though. This might be problems for Aziri's. Bolting back to base.
Zoom.
With the home guard boots.
They just need to stall out this fight. They've got plenty of poke potential from this Corki here.
Dandy's about to pop back in a mini now though. Gonna have to build that rage back up and OMG instantly start the Baron when that happens. Uzi!
Oh, he's trapped in the pit.
Not good time, but it might be enough. They're gonna go straight in for it, Sarn! Huge play there with the All-Star pole. Well, Pwang's already got the kill on to go going. World Six jumps onto Uzi. He gets stunned out by the Braum passive as Dandy autos him. And a double there from Corki. Pwang's gonna make it three. He gets a double himself. Fifth Dragon's up. Dandy's gonna find Cool. That's the ace. And that should be game to Vici.
Vici just beat OMG single-handedly in a best of five. They've done it all game long. We talked about Vici are a one-trick pony. If they get to play the style, they'll just dominate it. They got it for the first two games. OMG came out swinging for the third set with a Kassadin pickup. Cool going back to his assassin roots. But OMG, excuse me, Vici, continue to evolve, look great for the playoffs, show off a new, unique style, and put OMG down.
I can see how you got them confused, but it is Vici Gaming that win the final game and push 3-1 over OMG into the next round of the playoff gauntlet. And I'm not going to say a new style, but definitely a new take on their old style. Much more aggressive, much more proactive, and that man right there, Marta, made the plays.
Dismantling the dynasty.
That one wasn't a dismantle, that was a brutal smashing. Let's be honest, Cool leans back in his chair, tried everything they could. OMG had a really good run in that set. I think the 3-1 is a less close scoreline than the series might indicate, but OMG couldn't find it in games 1 and 2, and Vici really powered back in the 4th to catapult themselves one step closer to the playoffs here. The gauntlet's tough. OMG will bow out. Another relatively low-placed playoff finish for them. And the Magic, we thought it might be back, but it's not there just yet.
They just cannot get their roster together. You know, falling to Vici, who had a very late rotating roster, pulling Pwang and Xuan over Endless and Hutong, I think in week 8 out of 11 in the LPL. Yeah, LPL plays a lot of games, so they got decent booth time, but they haven't been with this roster for the majority of it, now making a fairly convincing playoff run. That looked the best Vici has all year.
I agree. And OMG were looking very good, but they'll have to look now towards perhaps that Worlds qualifier. Try and get in shape for that, because you know OMG absolutely love the World Championships. But Vici Gaming are the ones that step one, advance one bracket further through the gauntlet. But do not be mistaken, Froskuren. It is still a gauntlet. So gauntlet for a reason. Real tough to run through, but Vici going to win their first match they have to play in it. Looking good.
Who do they face next? Is it LGD?
No, I think they made top. It already pushed up a couple of slots.
Then it's either Snake or LGD.
Well, it's given the teams that made playoffs,
eight
and the OMG and M3 are already gone, and Vici, of course, just won. The five teams left are going to be really good. Not to say the other two were bad, but it doesn't get easier. That's the whole point, the whole brutality of a gauntlet style.
But OMG fans, do not fret. It doesn't mean that they're out of the world qualifier. So how it works is that the top five teams with the most circuit points get invited to the world qualifiers. No one is guaranteed a spot, although I think EDG actually are guaranteed a spot. They have so many circuit points. That said, if, you know, one of the teams that can bump OMG out of it earn a bunch of points. So if Vici finishes very highly in this LPL playoff, they could possibly lose their invitation.
Well, for now, though, it's out of their hands, and Vici Gaming advance 3-1 for a very impressive win in the gauntlet. Join us tomorrow as the LPL promotion and playoffs will continue. But for myself, Frostcurrent, Rusty, and our entire production crew, we'll see you tomorrow night.